Another absolute monster-sized modern jet kit from Italeri crosses the bench, courtesy of Model Rectifier Corporation, MRC. They said, you don't have the time to build a monster like this for the show and get it done in a couple days, but they wanted my cool viewers to get a look at this thing, and it is out now, available. I will link down in the description, as always, where you can snag this. It is kit 2513, 1/32 scale, 100% new kit. Let's take a look at everything that's going to be in here. You're going to have the decals to build up to 4 different versions, and of course the aftermarket is going to support this thing like you wouldn't believe. Let's start looking at these trees on this thing. I'm not going to name off every part. I'm just going to let you look at the outstanding detail. Panel lines, look at the size of that. 1/32 scale jets are absolutely massive. They're silly big, and they allow you to get a level of detail in there and accentuate it with your own super detailing and aftermarket parts. And I'm sure companies like Edward are gonna have all kinds of stuff for this kit. But I mean, just look at that, like radar screens and small, super fine details. And this is just the first tree. Also, look at that, cockpit gauges. Now, I'm also going to have each sprue in its own photo with a black background. When we get to the end of the video, I'm going to set them all on the side and then pull them all out. Now, we've got 2 identical trees that are this one. Look at the tanks there, the mounts. Check out the detail. Oh, exquisite. I wish they made cars with this level of detail. They do some, but they really don't go into it because jet model makers are a special crew onto themselves. They just go insane for the level of detail. You can hardly tell the difference between the real one and the model one when these guys get done with a kit of this level. You get 2 trees that look like that. We'll set those on the side of the bench because there's just no room for them all. We get 2 identical trees for armament. Look at the size of that missile, as long as my hand. It's a kit in itself, just for all the rockets, mounting, the fins, everything is keyed, it fits in. These things, these kits do cost a pretty penny, but when you think of all that's in them and all the detail, that it's worth every single penny when you go after these things. Check out the wing detail. It's got the folding wings, the mechanism right there. Look at the panel lines, the rivet detail, the thin trailing edges on them where you can attach your ailerons. Molded like that. Modern molding is just always such a beautiful mystery to me. That part is in there, it was just loose in the box. Look at that. Intakes on the side there. Gorgeous panel line details. It's just going to absorb your wash, your weathering, your detailing. Everything is going to be exquisite. And from my experience with Italeri kits, and I've built quite a few for the show, they always go together so nicely. And this being an all-new modern one, I would anticipate exactly the same. Look at the size of this tree for the fuselage. I got some big hands. This stuff is massive. Look inside there for access panels. All nice rivet and panel lines. Look at inside the gear. Just delightful. Love looking at these. I wish I had the time. These are my retirement kits. Down the road, when I'm an older old man, and I can go ahead and spend a month on a kit, I will crack these bad boys out. Maybe there'll be something different than YouTube at that point. Check out the detail on those. Oh, look at the fin. See how thin that is? A thin fin? Or these are actually the tail planes. I'm sorry. The elevators on the back. Beautiful detail. That's why I don't try to name everything. I'm not an expert on jets. I just like building model kits. There's our fin. Look at that thing. All the little accoutrements. Check out the landing gear. Oh, these are so cool. I wish I had that much spare time. This thing's going to take a long time to do it justice. We're on the last giant tree. All those parts in that kit. Look at those intakes. Multi-part. Look at this. Look at the feathering right here. That's cast in. It's so thin. I'm moving it with my fingers so you can see it's just like feathers. Molded open. Nothing in between them. The pressure on those molds must be intense to get that kind of detail in there. And they're super thin. Look at that. It's just crazy. Gets me excited seeing these things. I hear about a new one coming out. They're like, would you put it on the show? I'm like, heck yes. You know, I love model kits and I don't care about the genre or the scale. Show me a cool model kit and it will get on the show. Let's look at some of the paperwork before we get back to the plastic parts. Look at this manual. It is a book and it's gorgeous. Look at the drawings in there, the instructions. I mean, really breaking everything down into multiple parts. It's not just one big drawing with 400 parts going on this one. There are a total of 6 parts going on that one. 3-4 parts at a time. Really lets you go through the pages and just see how simple it is. It's really not hard to assemble these. It's the detailing that takes the time. But I mean, just exquisite. They're not overwhelming you with information. They're letting you do little steps at a time and you work your way through it. Huge manual, big old sheet of photo etch. Folks, this much photo etch would normally run you $30 aftermarket. Italeri's got it in the box. Beautiful, left it in that background there, that white card so it doesn't get bent and you can see all the detail on there. Just wonderful. We're still not done. A full color painting and decal guide is in the box. No mistake about it. You will make sure that if you are really intense on making sure that your models are absolutely factory perfect, they've got full color guides, decal guides for the 4 versions. Exactly where to put everything. No mistakes. The interior colors, anything you want is all in that beautiful full color guide. Still not done with the paperwork. Huge decal, water slide sheet. Every single detail covered in exquisite color. Look at this. Look at the walkways. All printed for you. Never had an issue with those kind of decals. I mean, that's an enormous decal sheet. You're gonna spend a long time decorating that one. We'll get a little more up close. We'll go through each one. Pause the video at any point. Filming in HD so all my cool peeps can see every little tiny thing. And there will be still shots at the end. Finally, we're getting to the last parts in the kit. We've got a clear parts tree. We've got a vinyl parts tree. I don't know what these are. Are they the boots for the wings that fold back? I'm not sure. They're pretty cool looking. Look at this. These are almost the size of car tires in 1/25th scale. Landing gear, everything. Nice vinyl, beautiful tread. Got manufacturer's names all the way around it. And these mystery parts, tell me in the comment section what these are. Are they the bladder for the folding wings or what are they? And a gorgeous cockpit glass, no injection marks or seams down the center or the sides or big punch marks. Molded beautifully clean. They know modern jet builders demand that. Excellent detail, easy to mask off. All the little lights and accessories. Well, that's all the parts that are in the huge new Tornado GR.4 1/32nd scale. Once again, I will link below and I'm gonna have still shots at the end of the video so you can see each sprue individually. We'll see you at the next review.